dynamic. It's stretchy.
Pick this guy up.
So for me, that's from like my arm to whole, full arms like that. So do a whole stretch out like that, and then let go of the tail. So you fold it down. So see what you have now? You have a bend in the rope right there.
That looks like an 8.
Yep.
That's a figure 8. So to tie into your harness, what you're gonna do is tie a rewoven figure 8. So what we're gonna do first, so we're gonna go up through our leg loops. You can unclip that stuff for me. Get it out of the way. And then up through your waist belt. And then pull that through. So you're gonna want your knot tight into your harness. You don't wanna pull it through, but you want your knot tight to your harness, like an inch or 2 inches away. So then what we're gonna do is retrace this knot. So which, take your tail and see where the rope comes from your harness.
Yep.
You're gonna go in right there. And you know, it's a lot easier too if you leave your knot loose in the beginning. Makes it a lot easier to tie. So yep, go through and right there. So an easy way to, so what we're gonna do is retrace this. So take your tail and just kind of trace around. So it goes around and then comes through right there. Yep. So pull that through. So you want to pull that slack through. Yep. And then we're going to keep retracing. So it comes around. Awesome. Yep.
Excellent, Josiah.
You got it.
Figure eight.
See, that's a rewoven figure eight. So you want to make it look nice and symmetrical like this. So to tighten it, just pull on opposite ends of the knot like that, and opposite strands. All right. So now, see how we have this tail? Yep, that's right. Yep, look for, try and take smaller steps sometimes too. These big high steps like that can be really hard. Yep, stand up on that foot, there you go. Nice job. Try and smear. That's a huge foot, that's kind of like a, and that one you can just stand on any which way. But so like, see right there, you know, we really couldn't smear on that. So what we want to do, put the inside of our toe like that and we're gonna really put our big toe on it. And stand up on it. We just stand up on that, and then we probably have to smear again here. So you stand up like that. But so edging is, so really when you're standing up on those foot, what I want you to do is commit to that foot. So really push up, then you find your, you want to look around, yep, you'd be like, okay, so I'm gonna stand there. So push up and commit to that foot. I don't want you kind of like, you know, you're looking up here and then you're like, oh, okay, there's my foot. And then you look away and you're not looking at your feet and your foot's just going to be kind of. So yep, look at that foothold. Yep. Stand up on it. Nice. So look. Really look where you're going to see, like, and there's like, you're looking for these little things like right in there. Nice.
Excellent.
Hand right in there. So see how you just,
really nice.
Yeah, twist your hand in there. There you got the idea of the hand jam.
Yeah.
And then sometimes, you know, all you get is like a couple fingers in there or something. And sometimes you gotta like, one hand fits better. And sometimes, you know, like, that way's all right. Mm-hmm. That way's all right. So thumbs down sometimes is better. Like that way, see, jamming my hand in like that isn't very good, but I put my hand in like that, I get a pretty solid lock in there.
It's facing like this. So what we're gonna do is just, you're gonna pull back like this and like that. But when you're laying back, you really wanna keep your feet close to your hands.
Just a little there.
Yeah.
Yep.
Feet closer to your hands. No, no. Pull your feet up.
Keep your feet up. Yep. But sometimes you gotta bump one, like match your left foot and then bump your right foot up. Yep. Then bump your left foot again.
Good. Keep going.
Keep going.
Lay back. That's it.
Yep.
That's it.
Yeah, then you could probably stand up right up on that right foot.
Yeah.
Here and here, and I fell up there.
So I'm gonna, you'd slide down and then this one.
That would catch me. So, but the idea is I'm gonna fall double the distance to my piece, because see, I'm above it, so I gotta fall to it, and then I have to fall past it. So if I'm 5 feet above it, how far would I fall? I'm falling double the distance.
You fall 5, you fall 10 feet.
Yep. And a little bit more too, because you have stretch in the room. Yeah, exactly. Okay, so there's gonna be three different pieces of gear that I'll place today. The first one I'll show you, these are called nuts or chocks. So these work on, here, if you wanna make, go like this, kinda. Here, spread your thumb a little bit. So these kind of work in constrictions. So what I do is I'll put it in a constriction, and then, so what happens is the rock is a lot smaller than the piece of metal, and the piece of metal just can't fit through that. So that way it doesn't come out. So here, I'll show you the rock.
Here, you can slide it up.
Well, see, the problem with that is it's a flare.
Oh, snap.
Oh, there's a spider, you see that? The problem with the nuts can be, though, that they're only for a downward direction. So see, if it lifts up like that way, it just comes right out.
Yeah.
So see, in that direction, it's super strong because the metal just can't come out there because the rock's holding it. So as long as the rock stays strong, this is going to hold. It pushes against the sidewalls there. And so when I pull on it, these lobes push even harder on the outside of the crack, or the inside of the rock, which makes it even harder for it to come out. So here.
Right there. Another.
So say like right there. See how the harder I pull, the more the cams push against the side of the rock. And it actually makes it harder for it, the tri-cam, to come out, which is what we're looking for.
Right there?
Yeah, we're gonna have to bump up tracking size. So let's see, in the pull on that. Both tied in here. And we're gonna be tied in with what's called a clove hitch. A hitch is different from a knot. Like a knot, see how this is an overhand knot?
Yeah.
That knot can exist without this carabiner. You know, it's tied on itself. But a hitch is, if it didn't have some other component to it, it doesn't work. So if I take, see how like right there that knot works? If I take my finger out, it just, there's nothing. So to make a hitch, what you do is make like a Mickey Mouse ear, and then another one over the top like that. So if they're on opposite sides, then you put them together. And you put the fucking carabiner through, pull it tight. Then I'm gonna say off belay. So I build an anchor, and I'm clipped into it. I'm gonna say off belay. So what you do then is unlock your carabiner, take the rope out. Yep, pull the rope out of the tube. Yep, and then you're gonna yell out to me and say, "Sam, you're off belay." You see that?
Okay. Sam, you're off belay.
Thank you. So I'm gonna say, okay. And then what's gonna happen is I'm gonna pull up all the rope until it comes tight to your clove hitch. And at that point, you're gonna yell up to me and say, "Sam, that's me." And that lets me know that the rope's tight to you.
Yep.
And then I'm gonna put you on belay. And then I'll say, "Josiah, you're on belay." And at that point, you can take your clove hitch out of the carabiner. Okay? But before, like, don't do anything to this until I say you're on belay, okay? That's really important. So then I say you're on belay. you unclip from the clove hitch. And then you're gonna eventually, then you'll take this gear out and clip it all to you. You're gonna take the anchor with
you. Harness, your gear loops. See how you dropped that?
Yeah.
You gotta goodbye. Keep clipped in. Alright, so potentially what you might have to do, leave that piece in there.
Alright,
so you want to lean back. So put your back to the wall, just like I am. Okay? And lean on the rope. Lean on the rope. All your weight. Okay? You want to keep your brake hand down by your hip. So remember, don't take your brake hand off. Keep it down by your hip. That's gonna give you better friction. So, all right, so start.
Josiah, lock your brake hand by your hip.
Yep, you got it.
So okay, that's it.
Work. Yep, keep leaning back.
Feet in front of you.
Try and keep your feet equal distance apart, like shoulder width apart.
So how far do I get that all the way?
You're gonna go all the way to the dirt, and then I'm gonna run around and come get you, okay? Mm-hmm. You'll see, it's...
Once I hit that niche, stop for a little while, and then keep going.
Nope. See where the ground is right there? See the dirt? You're going right to there. Okay?
Feet apart. Sit your butt right back.
This part's a little hard because you're just kind of...
Sit your butt right back. Lock your hand next to your
waist. So just keep walking backwards. It works really... Just let the slack feed through your brake hand. You don't have to kind of like keep moving it up. So this is going to be the trickiest part, right when you get to the edge. So keep getting your feet to the edge. Hey, I got you on a backup right here, so you're all right. So
put all your weight in the harness. Right
there, and just let your butt drop a little bit more.
Feet straight.
Straighten your legs. All right, now start walking your feet down. Keep that hand low on the brake strand. There you go.
Feet out in front of you, Josiah. That's it. Feet out in front.
I got you backed up.
Right hand at your side. There is it.
Keep leaning back.
Good job.
Sweet. See, that's a lot easier there, right?
Keep an eye on the time.
We got an hour before. Okay, now walk your feet down.
Excellent, Josiah. Try it again. Bounce, release, catch. See how far you can go.
I'd rather not. Hey, gross.
Look at that, huh? Bounce way out.
No.
No, that'll give you a feel for it. You look good. Look at that, huh? No, don't touch it.
It's nice.
Yeah. Look at this view, huh?
So if you guys look, there's a big handhold right here. And then there's another huge one right here.
Great.
So pretty easy.
Josiah, neat, huh? Take your time. Okay. Just sign it right over here. That's it. Good foothold right on the edge. Right there. That's it. Good jug handles, huh? What? There you go, buddy. Look at that. Is there a handhold above you? In that crack? There you go. Jug's over on your right. See the handhold on the right? Right? Your right hand up? There you go.
There's no footholds. Take that stuff.
Good one. Nice layback. Good, Josiah. Excellent.
You want to move to your right. So stand up where your right hand is. Yep, and then you're going to move to your right a little bit.
Okay.
Nope, I want you to... Yeah, actually cross under that one.
There's no more footholds here.
Remember, you're going to have to use those little ones again, okay? Remember what we were doing earlier?
This whole flat wall.
So look around.
Eleven, right?
11 year old is coming up.
Push hard. There you go. Nice.
Nice move, Josiah.
Remember to keep looking at your feet.
I want to do it.
Katie could do it.
Katie could climb that. Easily. With a rock
moon. Hey.
So come up right there, Josiah. You see how there's a big foot here?
Good move, Josiah.
Yep, look for those good feet.
Excellent.
Look at your feet, look at your feet.
All right.
Stand up on, see how you're laying again. You can't see your feet and your feet are gonna slide out. Get that foot underneath you.
There you go.
Nice.
All right, good move.
So if you wanna come the easier way, you wanna go right. But you wanna go the hard way, right?
Yeah.
All right.
Good job!
No,
wait, no, I wouldn't climb it.
Let's go to the good seat. Yep, that's right.
All right, all right, Josiah!
How was it? Did you like it?
Yeah.
Fun?
Do you just want to hop the fence?
Oh my goodness gracious! Well, I bet he's happy he made it.